Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel RF Design Basics. So in this lecture I am going to explain you about different types of power divider. So first of all, let us try to understand what is a T-junction power divider. As name suggests, it's a T-junction. That means the shape of this power divider will be something like T. So I can just make it like this. So this here power will be input, and here it is P1 and P2. That means power is dividing in two parts, P1 and P2. This power divider can be made using microstrip line or waveguide. We can find the input admittance as, if our impedance of one of the branches Z1 and another one is Z2, we can write the input admittance as 1 by Z1 plus 1 by Z2, which is the admittance of these two branches connected parallelly at the junction. And apart from that, there will be small amount of reactance due to the discontinuity of this power divider at junction. So we can say this is due to the junction capacitance. And if I assume this as zero, the junction capacitance as zero in ideal case, then the input admittance Y in will become 1 by Z1 plus 1 by Z2. And to have matched with the input characteristic impedance, like if I have characteristic impedance Z0, to have matching at the junction, we must have this input admittance equal to 1 by Z0. So you can write 1 by Z0 equal to 1 by Z1 plus 1 by Z2. Now we will try to understand the problem due to this different characteristic impedance and effect on its matching properties. So let us say we are designing a power divider which is dividing power in 2:1 ratio. So this is the input transmission line and these are the output transmission line, which is connected in parallel. Input characteristic impedance is, let's say Z0, which is 50 ohm for example, and output characteristic impedance are Z1 and Z2. We have to divide power in 2:1 ratio so that P1 by P2 equal to 2. So we will try to understand what is the problem if I have different characteristic impedance at the output ports. So to know that, let's say P in power is entering from the port 1, this is port 2 and port 3. Port 2 and port 3 are the output ports, port 1 is input port. Then the total power input from the port 1 will be half V0 square by Z0, where V0 is the voltage at the port, and P1 will be half V0 square by Z1, P2 will be half V0 square by Z2. So from here we can write this as P1 by P2 is 2:1, and P1 plus P2 must be equal to P in. So, and P1 is 2P2. P in. So P2 is P in by 3. Hence P1 will be 2 P in by 3. So you can write P1 as 2 by 3 P in, and P2 as 1 by 3 P in. From here P in is half V0 square upon Z0 into 2 by 3. And here it is 1 by 3 into half V0 square by Z0. So by equating this, this equation and this equation, we can get half is common, V0 square common. So Z1 equal to 3 Z0 by 2. And from the second equation, half cancelled, V0 square cancelled. So Z2 equal to 3 Z0. And we have already taken Z0 as 50 ohm. So Z1 will be, let's calculate that. Z1 will be 3 into 50 divided by 2 ohm, and Z2 will be 3 into 50 ohm. So these two characteristic impedance are 75 ohm and 150 ohm. So if I make a power divider having different characteristic impedance, we can show it like this. 50 ohm, 75 ohm and 150 ohm. And let us calculate the reflection coefficient looking into this port and this port. If I look into this port, this is the port 1, then gamma 1 we can say is equal to load will be 75 parallel 150. So 75 parallel 150 we can calculate as 75 into 150 divided by 75 plus 150. This is equal to 50. So reflection coefficient will be 50, that is ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0, which is equal to 0. So port 1 is matched. Now calculate for port 2. This is port 2. And port 2, when we are looking into port 2, the characteristic impedance is 75 ohm. And these are 50 ohm and 150 ohm, both are in parallel. So the load will be, for this 75 line, the load will be parallel combination of 50 and 150 ohm, and that 50 and 150 ohm will be 50 multiplied by 150 divided by 50 plus 150, and that is equal to 37.5. So the load reflection coefficient, or looking into the port 2, the reflection coefficient will be 37.5 minus 75 by 37.5 plus 75, which is equal to 37.5 minus 75 divided by 37.5 plus 75 equal to minus 1 by 3. And similarly, we can calculate reflection coefficient at port 3. Here 150 will be the line impedance, and 50 and parallel 75, 50 parallel 75 will be the load. So 50 parallel 75 is 50 multiplied by 75 divided by 50 plus 75 is 30 ohm. So gamma 3 is 30 minus 150 divided by 30 plus 150, which gives us 30 minus 150 divided by 30 plus 150. Is minus 2 by 3. So what we have seen here is, if we see the reflection coefficient at port 1, it is 0, it's matched, but port 2 is mismatched and port 3 is also mismatched. Although it is dividing power in two parts, at the junction, it is dividing into two parts, but when it is connected to a particular load, the power will be reflected back from there because of its mismatch at that particular port, and it will not be able to deliver all the power to the load. So due to that, this type of power divider is sparingly used. This can be used if there is a matching circuit designed at the output ports. So we have to design a matching circuit at these output ports, then only you can use this type of power divider. So to overcome this problem of having different mismatched ports on output ports, another method of designing the power divider was adopted, and that type of power divider was called as resistive power divider. In resistive power divider, the power divider design, so in this all the characteristic impedance was taken as Z0 only, and additional Z0 by 3 resistor is connected in series in all the three ports. So this is done so that all the ports will be matched. Let us calculate whether it is matched or not. So if I see from here, then these two are in parallel, and we have Z0 characteristic impedance with Z0 by 3 series resistance. So if you look into any of the port, the total impedance will be Z0 plus Z0 by 3, which is 4 Z0 by 3. And if I take parallel of these two lines, that means 4 Z0 by 3 will be added with another 4 Z0 by 3 in parallel. So the total impedance looking into this will be 4 Z0 by 3 parallel to 4 Z0 by 3. So this will become, if two impedance, same impedance in parallel, it will, the equivalent will be half of that, that is 2 Z0 by 3. So here if I look, it will be 2 Z0 by 3, the combination of these two output ports, here port 1, port 2 and port 3. Now this 2 Z0 by 3 is in series with Z0 by 3. So if I see from here, the impedance will be 2 Z0 by 3, which was already there, plus Z0 by 3. So this makes the input impedance looking from here equal to Z0. And the line impedance is already Z0, load impedance also becomes Z0, that means this port is matched. If you see port 2 and port 3, all are symmetric to port 1 only. It is same as port 1, so port 2 will be also matched, port 3 will be also matched. So we have designed a resistive power divider where all the ports are matched, but this is done at the cost of induced loss in all the three lines. So we have Z0 by 3 resistor, which will create loss, and some power will be dissipated in this resistor. Now let us assume that the voltage at this point is V1. At the junction it is V, and again at this point is V3. Similarly, here it is V2. So V1 is voltage just after the first line. V is at voltage at junction. V2 is voltage after this resistor. And V3 is voltage after this resistor. That means if I calculate these two voltages, I will be able to find out the power division and loss in this power divider. So first of all, this voltage will divide into two parts. One is Z0 by 3 from here to here. Another one is the junction impedance, that is 2Z0 by 3. So one is Z0 by 3 and 2Z0 by 3. So the voltage at junction will be V, which is equal to V1 dividing in two parts. One part is Z0 by 3, another part is 2Z0 by 3. So we are going to write voltage across 2Z0 by 3. So in the numerator it is 2Z0 by 3. Denominator it is the total sum of these two resistance, and which is nothing but 2 by 3 V1. So we have 2 by 3 V1 voltage at this point. That means 1/3 of voltage is dissipated in this resistor. Only 2/3 of voltage is available at junction. Now again, when we take this Z0 by 3 and Z0 combinedly, some of the voltage will be dissipated in this and some of the voltage will be available after this resistor. So to calculate that, let us write it as V2, which is also equal to V3, because V2 and V3 is same. So the junction voltage is V, and V is dividing in two parts, one in Z0 by 3, another one in Z0. So that we can write as V into Z0 by 3 plus Z0, because Z0 is voltage across, Z0 is impedance, and we have to calculate voltage across this. So Z0 is in the numerator and total impedance is Z0 by 3 plus Z0. So this is 3 by 4 V, which is equal to 3 by 4. V is 2 by 3 V1. So 3 cancel, 2, 4. We have half V1. So that means the voltage V2 and V3 is half V1. So if I just write S parameter, how we can write? All the three ports are matched. So we can write straightforward. S11, S22, S33 equal to 0. And then we have V2 equal to V3. It's dividing in half. So also it is reciprocal. From the network itself we can say this is reciprocal, because all the three ports look similar to each other. So whatever is entering here and dividing in two parts, same thing, same property will happen. If I give something here, it will divide in two parts. So this network is reciprocal. And the voltage ratio, if I give V1, I will get half V1, half V1 here. So if I give 1 volt, I will get half volt here, 0.5 volt there. So this will be half, 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 half. We can just write 1 by 2, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. So this is the S matrix of resistive power divider. So it has solved one problem, that all the ports has become matched. But another problem is that the power is dissipated into the resistor. That means if you are talking in terms of power, if I have V1 voltage, then at port 2 we will get half V1, port 3 we will get half V1. So if we talk in terms of power, that means we have to take square of this and square of this. So what will happen? If I have a power P input here, then this is 1 by 4 V1 square. 1 by 4 V1 square. It means that only half power is, only 1 by 4th of Pn is available here. And at port 3 also we have only 1 by 4th of Pn. So total power after division is only 1 by 2 Pn. So half of the power has been dissipated into the resistor. So this is due to this problem, we are going to design a new type of power divider, which will be known as Wilkinson power divider, and that we will explain in my next video.